Okay, so for the second joint, it's called prismatic joint within the Demeo Kinematics from CATIA. We'll start with this file, so prismatic joint, drag and drop that file. And we'll have these two parts. One is a fixed part and the other one is a slot. I will first define a new mechanism and a fixed part for that mechanism, the fixed element. Now I will define the prismatic joint. I need to set some lines, so this model from this edge, from the slot, I will need it to be coincident with this one, so it's like a puzzle. And now I need to define two planes. I can select the bottom plane. If I will hit length driven, click OK, it will snap automatically. And now I can do the simulation. So the current limits are minus 100 and 100 millimeters. If I will go, let's say minus 100, the part will move like this. I can increase that range by going over here on the three dots. I will want it to be from minus 500 up to 500. Now if I will go from 0 to minus 500, the piece will slide like this. As you can see, you can simulate even if the part is, let's say, going above the length of the part. Okay, so this is, let's say, the basics for this prismatic joint. What is important is that you can define using multiple edges. So as you saw before, I use those two edges. I can define the same prismatic by selecting this top edge and have it coincident with that top one. And for the plane, that and that. Again, length driven, and I will have the same functional mechanism with these two edges. Okay, so I can have it again simulated like this. So this was the first prismatic part. You can find that file in the description below on GrabCAD. Also, I have added another mechanism. It will be this. It's called product one. So it has this prismatic element. As you can see, if I will open the mechanism, I have three revolutes for the three upper element plus this prismatic joint at the bottom. If I will simulate it, okay, like that, set the interpolation step and they then play it in a loop mode like this, back and forth, I can simulate that. So we have looked at the revolute in the other video. Now I want to recreate this, so I will select all those, hit delete, delete all children, and let's do this mechanism again. So I see that I still have that fixed part. I will want to recreate it. So I want to create a mechanism. I already have this mechanism once, so I'll just set that fixed part for the base again. Now I will go with the joints. So I had this prismatic joint between this element. So if you are having problems selecting the edge, you can go with show hide. So I can right click and choose hide for that cube. Now I will go at the bottom where I have all the let's say hidden elements. I see that my cube is over here. I know that this edge and also this plane, I will want it to be coincident with that one. I will click OK. For this mechanism, I will want this to be the length driven. I want this to control the other elements. And now I will just add the revolute to have all the function elements simulated. So that axis, I will hide again the cube with the smaller axis, that surface with this surface with an offset of minus 5. I can send that back again. Over here I don't have to hide and show anything, so that one, with that one, the two upper surface. And I have the last one, revolut between the top element, the bottom orange element. And now I need to define that that plane with that plane will be, okay, I see that I have a surface over there, so I will hide that surface. I want to have a solid element over here as well. So let's see, I cannot reset that, so I will have to do it again. So let's see, to be easier, I will just hide that. And I will set it like this, revolut between that one, the top part. I will go with offset. The software will automatically calculate the distance. I had that surface over there because I used that surface as a new sketch where I defined those parts. So you can go with offset. The software will see automatically that I have a distance of 25 millimeters between those two. And if I click OK, I can start and simulate that mechanism. So again, I can go and redo the simulation. Now I went positive, so the slider will move in this direction as long as it still allows, let's say, this element to extend that far. Or I can go again with minus, like this, and I will see that the two joints will be overlapping so that the cube can slide in that direction. Okay, so this was the prismatic joint. We have worked on what we learned in the other video called revolut joint to define this mechanism over here. Okay, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment below or on the GrabCAD 3D model. Okay, so this was the prismatic joint. Thanks for watching.